So I just want to illustrate. My area of mathematics is something called topology. Topology is a sort of geometry where you don't worry about angles and lengths, all the stuff you may have done at school. You just worry about connections between things. This is the first, I want to tell you, this is actually a cover. It's not an original theorem of mine. It's a cover. It's a somebody else's theorem. And it's something that a man called Leonard Euler, he talked about old things. This goes back to 1736. And Euler was a Swiss mathematician, a remarkable man, and he visited a place called Königsberg. So this is a map of Königsberg. Königsberg was the capital of East Prussia, and there's a river goes through it, and there are two islands in the river. So this is the north bank, this is the south bank, this island here, and then there's a bigger island here. And there were these various bridges between the islands and the banks of the river. And the inhabitants of Königsberg liked on a Sunday afternoon to go for walks around the city, and as you do, it's always fun crossing bridges. And so they gave this sort of little teaser for the residents of Königsberg to try and find a path around Königsberg which crossed each bridge once and only once. So the idea is to find a route walking around the city. There were seven bridges, and the idea is you go over each bridge once and only once. So this was a problem. People actually couldn't find such a route. They struggled to do this. So now what mathematicians do, as well as doing sums, they actually prove sometimes that things are possible and sometimes prove that things are impossible. And the thing about this, one of the things you have to do with it if you're a mathematician is to try and extract the essence of a problem. So in this problem, the length of the bridges doesn't matter, the size of the islands doesn't matter. All that matters, there are two land masses, four pieces of land, and there are these bridges. So you can do a model of this the map of the city by just simplifying it, just having a dot for each piece of land and a line for each bridge. And if you do that, it finishes up looking like this. So there's just four dots because there are four pieces of land. And then the two bridges from this island to the north bank, these two red lines here, and the two bridges to the south bank, two more. And then the various bridges going to this bigger island are shown on as well. So we can forget this and just concentrate on this. So now, so what we have to try and find is a route around this. This is actually called a graph. It's a different use of the word graph. Around here, a route around here, which just goes along each red line once and only once. That's the idea. And what Euler proved, Euler was probably the greatest mathematician of the 18th century. Although he's Swiss, he did live in St. Petersburg quite a lot of his life. He was there, and he went blind towards the end of his life. After he was visiting Königsberg, he went blind. And when he went blind, he said, "Well, now I'll have less things to distract me, and I'll be able to concentrate on my mathematics." And he carried on doing mathematics even though he was blind. I have known some blind mathematicians, and I have various stories about them, but I don't think I have time to tell you them now. To come another time. So let's look at this again. So you've got to imagine, you've got to do a sort of thought experiment now. Supposing you have found a path around this thing going along each red line once and only once. And let's just look at this dot here. And imagine, so let's imagine that the path doesn't start at this point here. Suppose you started somewhere else. Then there are these three bridges or three edges going to that point. And at some point, if you're going to go along each edge once and only once, you'll arrive at that red, black dot, having arrived along one of these three red edges. And that will have used up one of these edges. Then having got there, your path, what are you going to do next? Well, you've got to carry on from there, so you leave along one of the other red edges, and then you carry on wandering around, and you've still got another red edge that's finishing up at that point to use up, and so at some point, in order to go along that edge, you'll have to arrive along that edge, and when you get there, there's nowhere to go because you've been along all three bridges or three edges at that point. So you've arrived, you've left, you've come back, and then there are no more red lines. So that must be the end of the path. So if you didn't start at this point, you must finish there. And the reason for that is there is an odd number of red lines going there. But then you look at the other points and you see this one here also has three red lines coming out of it. So if you don't start there, you've got to finish there. And the bottom one here has three, so if you don't start there, you've got to finish there. And this one has five coming out, so if you don't start there, you've got to finish there. So what you conclude is, if you have a path around here, you've got to start and finish No, at each all the 4 points. But any path has one starting point and one ending point, so you can't do it. Did you follow that?
Yeah.
that's typical mathematics, that's a theorem. And you can go on and explore other versions of it, and that was what Euler proved. And it's actually published as a proper mathematics paper in the beginning of the early years of the 18th century. I'm a topologist, and that's what I did all day. I sort of walked along bridges and things like that.